रेडी एट द वेरी आउटसेट, सर आई माइट सबमिट दैट आई हैव नो हेजिटेशन इन ऑफरिंग माई कंग्रेचुलेशन टू द रेलवे मिनिस्टर फॉर द गुड फाइनेंशियल पोजिशन ऑफ आवर रेलवेज एज इंडिकेटेड इन हिज स्पीच ऑन द रेलवे बजट फॉर द ईयर 2009-10. देयर हैज ऑल्सो बीन अ फॉल हैज स्पीकर्स हैव मैंशनड बिफोर इन रेलवे गुड्स ट्राफिक एंड इन इनकम फ्राम पैसेंजर ट्राफिक. द फॉल इन गुड्स ट्राफिक हैज बीन एट्रीब्यूटेड बाई द रेलवे अथॉरिटीज टू अनफेयर कंपिटिशन फ्राम प्राइवेट ऑपरेटर्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट वर्किंग ऑन लाइन्स पैरेलल टू द रेलवेज एंड द पैसेंजर ट्राफिक डिक्लाइन हैज बीन एट्रीब्यूटेड टू नेचुरल इकोनॉमिक कंडीशंस प्रिवेलिंग इन द कंट्री. इन रिगार्ड टू द फॉल इन गुड्स ट्राफिक आई एग्री दैट इट इज़ द कंसर्न ऑफ द रेलवेज टू इंश्योर दैट द इनकम शुड नॉट फॉल बट इट शुड बी सीन दैट दे डू नथिंग सो दैट द प्राइवेट ऑपरेटर्स ऑफ ट्रांसपोर्ट हु डू अ नेशनल सर्विस वुड गो आउट ऑफ एग्जिस्टेंस. इट इज ट्रू दैट द प्राइवेट ऑपरेटर्स हैव बीन एबल टू डिफाई कंपटीशन बाई द रेलवेज बट इट मस्ट हैव हैपेंड बिकॉज द प्राइवेट ऑपरेटर्स हैव गिवन इकोनॉमिक एंड ऑपरेशनल एडवांटेज विच द रेलवेज कुड नॉट गिव एंड इनक्लाइन टू से दैट इफ द रेलवे अथॉरिटीज गिव द सेम एडवांटेज इकोनॉमिक एज वेल एज ऑपरेशनल आई एम श्योर दैट दे विल गेट बैक ऑल द क्लाइंट्स हु हैव गॉन अवे फ्राम देम. आई होप द रेलवे अथॉरिटीज एंड द गवर्नमेंट वुड लुक इन टू दिस मैटर इन दिस व्यू एंड डू नथिंग सो दैट द प्राइवेट ऑपरेटर्स गो आउट ऑफ एग्जिस्टेंस. देयर इज ग्रेट नीड फॉर दीज प्राइवेट ऑपरेटर्स एंड सो आई रिपीट दैट द रेलवे अथॉरिटीज शुड थिंक ट्वाइस एंड शुड गिव दियर ड्यू अटेंशन बिफोर टेकिंग एनी रॉन्ग स्टेप दैट वुड ड्राइव दीज ऑपरेटर्स फ्राम दियर ऑपरेशंस. द फॉल इन पैसेंजर ट्रैफिक आई होप इज अ टेम्परेरी फीचर एंड आई होप ऑल्सो दैट इट विल बी ऑल राइट वेन बी रिकवर फ्राम द कंडीशंस विच बी पास्ड थ्रू लास्ट ईयर. द स्पीच ऑफ द रेलवे मिनिस्टर इंट्रोड्यूसिंग द बजट हैज बीन अ वेरी प्लीजेंट एंड गुड वन. There has been improvement in every sphere and activity of the railway administration. The rolling stock has increased considerably and practically we have met all the demands in this respect. I make a special mention of the engines and locomotives which come out of Chitranjan workshop and Telco workshop. There has been increase of amenities to passengers which is evident every day when we travel on the railways. The welfare of railway officers working in the railway administration has been considerable and all our thanks are due to the railway administration for this care of their officers. This happy position should not, however, lead to a sense of complacency and undue safety on the part of the railway authorities. The railway minister has already many problems which have defied solution up to date, and he has to work hard and long for solving them. I would only refer to overcrowding in trains, failure of trains to travel in scheduled time, increase in accidents, ticketless traveling, insanitary condition of rest houses, फॉर लोअर क्लास पैसेंजर्स एंड पुअर क्वालिटी ऑफ फूड. एज रिगार्ड्स ओवर क्राउडिंग इन ट्रेन्स, इट इज प्लेन टू एवरीबडी हु गोज बाय ट्रेन दैट देयर इज ओवर क्राउडिंग टूडे एवरीवेयर. दिस इज स्पेशली नोटिस्ड इन सब अर्बन ट्रेन्स. Sights of passengers hanging on whatever support is available in the trains or traveling on footboards are not rare, and during the holiday season and on special occasions, the roofs of trains are also taken into service. I know that some passengers take to these dangerous modes of traveling to avoid payment, but it can be safely said that these would disappear if there was no overcrowding. I referred to amenities to passengers provided by the railway administration, but they do lose their value when we see the travelers being huddled together in conditions which are more fit for animals than human beings. I hope this question, which is of very great importance to the railways, should be seriously looked into by the Honorable Railway Minister. The failure of trains in reaching at the scheduled time is a matter which has been more than once before the House and elsewhere, and when the Railway Minister tried to explain the situation, there were pleas of laughter which showed that the Minister had not satisfied us. I would not like to speak much on it, but this should also be attended to seriously, and the sooner it is done, the better. The railway accidents have increased, which is most unfortunate. I know that the railway authorities do realize the importance and gravity of this question and are trying to consider the matter seriously from a three-pronged attack, namely psychological, educative, and punitive. If punitive measures are required, I feel that such measures should be taken severely and effectively. Any light-hearted punitive measures will not help. At the same time, I feel that something is lacking in the railway organization. Sir, the President's address has been discussed in this August House for 3 full days. I understand that 37 speeches have already been delivered. The debate has touched upon various aspects of the problems affecting our country. I have followed it with close interest and care. The President's address gives a picture of the country as a whole. It is intended to place before the House the full program for the future, the methods that we propose to adopt, the program for progress that has been chalked out, and the achievements that have so far been recorded. A picture like that has to be viewed from a correct angle. It is necessary that a sense of perspective and proportion should be maintained. If one does not try to take a balanced view of things or looks at the picture from an acute angle, then the judgment must be distorted. One should not allow his vision to be obstructed by individual happenings. The House has been a favorable view of the address, and it has commended itself to the approval and support of the good sense and wisdom of the House. I am grateful to the honorable members for their support in general to the basic policies which have been set forth in this address.